Finally tonight, an unusual place, a grand space, and a showcase for contemporary art. Jeffrey Brown visits the new Whitney Museum in New York.
Like all buildings, it begins as a construction site.
Everything needs to be ready, so there will be a moment where...
And when we visited the new Whitney Museum recently, work was going on all around. Architect Elisabetta Trezzani managed the project with world-renowned museum builder Renzo Piano. On a large outdoor terrace, she told us of their mission here.
To create places that are connected with a neighbor and all the city.
So the city is the canvas in a way.
Exactly. Yeah.
And what a neighborhood this is, or was. Trezzani told me of her first time here.
When we came, only the meatpacking district was working 24 hours, yeah. And there was blood on the streets.
There was blood on the streets, yeah.
This is New York's meatpacking district, long a busy and messy and once dangerous area where few residents or tourists ventured. Now it's a bustling neighborhood in a new way, with restaurants and high-end shops. The new museum is adjacent to New York's High Line, a hugely successful above-street-level park that attracts thousands of visitors every day for an almost whimsical walk through the city. The Whitney, which certainly has a ship-like look with the Hudson River on its other side, becomes a kind of anchor for this new area. It lived in its old area, Manhattan's Upper East Side, for 48 years and made its name as a showcase for American art and contemporary artists eager to push boundaries. But times changed, and a move to a larger new building in a new area was necessary.
It was a little bit like getting a suit when you're a young person, and you love that suit, and it's a great suit, but you bit by bit outgrow that suit. And we outgrew the building.
Adam Weinberg has been director of the Whitney for 12 years. Now he and his team of curators have a $422 million building with 8 stories, 200,000 square feet, beautiful and large new galleries to play with.
All of the walls in the galleries are not fixed. You can tear down any wall and build anything you want in any of these spaces, mm-hmm. which is pretty extraordinary.
Weinberg also knows that something else has changed in American culture, the competition for our time and attention. These days, museums like ballparks, video games, and so much more promote themselves as experiences.
Art has always been about an experience. I mean, people stand in front of art to have a connection to something. So there's the experience where you do it with thousands of people, and there's something great about that collective energy. And there are times when you're in the museum, there are lots of people around you. But there's also that wonderful feeling when you happen to be in a gallery and there are not that many people around, and you actually get to spend time with a work of art.
Fred Wilson is an artist who spent a lot of time with museums. He's made them his subject. Long ago, he himself worked as a museum guard, and that led to this sculpture, now in the Whitney.
I always felt like we were on display, just like
you
everything.
Were on display.
That's right.
Like the guards. The work.
The guards was on display like the work. And but ironically, also, I felt invisible.
Many years later, Wilson is not only shown in the Whitney, he's on its board of trustees. In a city crowded with great museums, he's a true believer in the Whitney's particular mission.
What the Whitney gives artists is a partnership in risk-taking. You get the sense that the curators are really in your corner. Not that other curators aren't, but they really get it, that you have to do what you do, take the risk, and they're willing to go along with you with that risk. It's not the common situation for a major institution.
In its inaugural exhibition called America is Hard to See, many of those former risks are now on display, including works that were long consigned to storage for lack of space.
We really built this building to show the permanent collection.
Donna DeSalva is the museum's chief curator.
Is this true that some of these you just sort of found in the basement?
Well, we have them carefully in our storage area, work by Earl Rybeck, which is pretty extraordinary, and using the TV as this creative medium in this way is one we really have not shown in many, many years. So great revelation for us. Mm-hmm. And the idea of the television in that 60s moment, mm-hmm. you know, is such a rich idea.
Well, so in addition to being able to show a lot of things you couldn't, was there a theme?
Our title, America's Hard to See, is because it's impossible mm-hmm. to sum up what American art is. It's not a greatest hit show. It's not a highlight show. It's really a sort of thematic interpretation of different preoccupations across 115 years that come up over and over and mm-hmm. over for artists.
A quiet moment in the new galleries, but not for architect Trezani.
Do you like this moment when everything's sort of raw and everybody, you know, the workers are all around
yeah,
us?
Yeah, I'm just waiting that they arrive like tomorrow.
When you just want it to open?
Yes, yes.
Enough of this.
I just want to see people inside and I want to look their face.
She'll get her chance tomorrow when the museum opens its doors to the public. From the new Whitney Museum in Lower Manhattan, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.